Welcome to Coach's Corner. Here we are on January 10th, well into the season already. Frank Panarelli, the girls' hockey coach, joining us here tonight. And, of course, Nick, Billy, Bobby, and myself. It's been a couple of – we haven't been on.
Not together.
Yeah, I know, for a long time.
We got all over you the last time because you missed.
I know. I wasn't there. Frank, big move this year up to Division I. I mean, you played Division I teams last year, too.
We do, yeah.
I mean, didn't you play that Notre Dame that won the state championship last year?
Yes. Notre Dame actually won the Division II championship, championship 2 years. But we played probably half our schedule was Division I.
Okay.
So, but this year we moved up literally to Division I. So
you're playing against the big girls now all the time.
Right? Yeah, we have our league games and we go towards Boston. We play, you know, Winthrop, Billerica. You know, we stacked our schedule pretty strong. We played Notre Dame, Hingham twice this year, Needham. So,
now the there's three schools that we currently draw from: ours, Westboro, and Wachusett.
Yes, and we had St. Peter Marion, which the girls that were they started their own program, but the two girls that played for us last year had the opportunity to play for us or go with St. Peter's. They stayed with us, so they had that. They gave them the option to stay
so
with us, which they did.
In.
They were grandfathered in, and we're glad
and
they
how
did.
How old are they?
They're both juniors. So they're both impact players for us, which I'm glad they stayed. St. Peter's going to have some growing pains. They didn't want to play us or join our league this year, which I understand. So they want to kind of ease into the schedule. They didn't want to come out and join our league.
I was talking to the girls, and they said that St. Peter's got a lot of 7th and 8th grade.
Yes, they have a young team.
And, I mean, really, isn't that how you started, too?
Right. Well, the girls on tonight, I mean, all of them, I had two girls, Lilly and Kai, been with me for 6 years. Karli's been 5 years. Delaney's been 5 years, but she'll be 6 years next year. She's only a junior.
Yeah.
But we did away with the junior 7th and 8th graders. We just have high school now.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, so Delaney's class is the last one to be that would be able to play for 6 years.
Now, why? Why would you do that? Why did you do that? Is it
because we had enough
established now?
Yeah, we had enough of the other co-op, enough kids. We did it for a number of reasons before. We just didn't have enough numbers. So we had the 7th and 8th graders.
So how many on the team?
Right now we have 22.
And how about half Shrewsbury?
There's probably 9 Shrewsbury kids or something like that, and there's 5 or 6 Wachusett. So it's between the other schools, it gives us a full team. We still need the help.
Are you the only Division I team from Central Mass?
Central Mass West is actually. Long Meadow's actually. They moved us in Long Meadow up to 1.
And you played Long Meadow?
We did earlier in the season. It was actually a really good game. We were losing 3-2, and we went to the third period. We ended up beating them 6-3. We scored 4 goals in the third period. Wow. But they're a big rival with us. You know, they're a very good team.
Yeah.
So how many years is this now, Frank, since you've been coaching?
This is the 10th year of the program, my 10th year.
Year number 10.
Coach.
You've come a long way, baby. I remember not being funded. And,
Asking for money.
Asking
for money all the time on the show.
They raised money for a lot, long time. You know, we became a school sport 3 years ago.
Did you get to 50 wins yet?
last year was a good year. We did. We had a couple milestones last year. We hit 100 wins last year.
Good for you.
Early
good
in the season, then Delaney hit 100 points last year. Early in the season, so
God
it was a nice milestone last year. But
we always say that when we get the coaches on, we talk to Lee and to Adrian and these guys, and we say in baseball, if they win or lose by a run or two, it's coaching. In basketball, it's win or lose by 5, it's coaching. What is it in hockey? 1 goal?
Yeah.
2 goals?
A 2 goal lead is probably the most dangerous lead in hockey because you kind of back off a little bit. But yeah, it's 1 goal, 2 goals.
So you get a lot of close ones.
Yeah, we do.
I always hated 2-1 games because I always sat there and said, the next goal wins no matter what.
Right.
If they tie it up, they're going to win. Yeah. And if we go up 3-1,
it's
over.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. No, it's true.
It's tough.
It is
it's tough.
It's
hockey's tough.
Yeah,
and you're playing a tough schedule. And you're in a bus a lot.
We travel, you know, quite a bit. You know, what's nice is anything over an hour, they give us a nicer bus. It's a glorified school bus, but it has equipment underneath. Yeah, we can put the stuff underneath. The seat's a little more comfortable.
See,
but
there was a method to his madness, right?
Yeah. Jay takes care of us on that because we do. We played Beverly. You know, we go out that way.
That's a long ride.
Yeah, we played Beverly earlier this year. You know, we'll go out to Winthrop, which is, you know, past the airport in Boston. So we do travel.
Is there any home and home?
Yes, Notre Dame and Hingham's doing a home and home with us. A lot of teams will only play us if we go to them. So
really?
That's why Bill Ricker.
Is it because you're new to Division One?
No, I think it's just they. What they happens is a lot of teams that we play are in big leagues, so they don't really need a lot of out of league games. We're the opposite. We don't have a lot of league games, so we got to find. Really? I had to find 13 games this year. So you have to go outside our league, and a lot of teams will play us once. But I just want the competition.
Now, boys in Division One, they got Super Eight. Do you have Super Eight?
Girls? No.
No,
they just do a Division One and Division Two.
How does that work, like the playoffs? When you get in Division One playoffs, is it the whole state goes into a pool? So you know, like play Central and Western
no,
Mass.
No,
and
the you just play you know Eastern. One through four eight, usually gets a bye, and then they just do play
it out. Is it, and it's based on record?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. And then they're going to change that to the index, strength of schedule, which is good because there are some teams that qualify that get in by playing a weak schedule. You know, and they benefit by that, which they shouldn't be.
But see, I've also seen the other way too, where back in the 90s when we played in our first, I think it was the first state hockey championship with the boys, we played Linfield, I think it was Linfield, and they had a 13-6 record, you know, Division III. I'm like, how did they make the finals? And then we played them. They played like 15 of their games against Division II and Division I competition.
Makes you a better team.
Yeah, makes you a better team. So
absolutely.
Did you have to cut this year?
No, we can't cut. Everyone, when you're a co-op, it's everyone makes a team.
Oh.
So there are girls that come out that never played hockey before, so I try to have the parents come watch a couple tryouts before they go out and buy all this equipment. And, you know, it's a big commitment. And they see that
wow,
these girls,
tough.
It's not, you just can't pick up ice hockey. So they see the girls are really good. And I try to explain to them it's just not a sport you can just go and start playing. Because a lot of them say, well, they've been figure skating. I say, well, that's fine, but you're not playing hockey.
Right.
You know, it's a lot different than figure skating.
Completely different.
Absolutely. And a lot of parents see that right away, and they, I just don't want their kid to get hurt or hurt one of our players because
so
they
many
really can't play that
how many people came out for this year's team?
We had the 22.
Oh.
So we had
so you did,
perfect
you just
amount.
Took them all.
Yes.
Okay.
Now, do they all pay fees?
Yes.
The same as Shrewsbury girls?
Yes.
Okay.
So Westboro in Westboro and West Wachusett pay the same $300 fee as Shrewsbury, and St. Peter's had to pay a little bit more because St. Peter's has a team now, so the school doesn't kick in for those girls. So the parents were just like, you know, we want them to stay in Shrewsbury. Again, like, I'm glad they did because they're good players for us.
Okay. Good.
So 6-0, I'm sure you go out and scout. And who's the is it Notre Dame of Hingham again?
Well, Notre Dame of Hingham for Division II. There's Notre Dame and Hingham, and now in one, it's Austin Prep, Woburn, who
Austin
won it last.
Prep, private school?
It's like a St. John's. It's like, you know,
will you be playing them prior to this?
No, we don't play them during the regular season, but Woburn's a real tough team. You know, but right now we're ranked in Mass State Hockey number one because we're still undefeated, Division One.
Oh, okay.
So Austin Prep just lost, you know, that to Bill Ricker, who we play. So we'll have an idea. Long Meadow just lost to Austin Prep 3-1. So we get an idea, and YouTube's nice because sometimes they show the games, so I can watch them online. So,
that was going to be my next question. You know how football now has huddle, where everybody's on huddle.
They're starting to do that with hockey. More boys, girls aren't doing it as much. But like I said, with the YouTube, a lot of like we went to play Natick the other night, and they had it on TV like we have here, so I got to watch that game.
Okay.
So. It is getting bigger for girls hockey. I mean, girls hockey, we have, I think there's over 90 teams between Division I and II in the state. We played Falmouth, Maine the other night. They have 18 in
the
whole
girls
state.
Yeah, were trying to explain that.
It was my fault. I booked it. We were looking for games. I seen Falmouth was looking for games. So I said, absolutely. So I called, talked to the AD, because I do a lot of it. I start in the summer trying to book games, because a lot of teams don't want to play us because they think we're going to be pretty good, so they don't want to play us.
Yeah.
So he goes, all right, I'll play her and everything. So I said, that's great. A month later, the Falmouth Mass coach called me to scrimmage. I was like, well, why would you want to scrimmage us? We're playing. We're not playing you. I said, yeah, we are. He goes, I talked to your AD. He goes, well, what's the name? I say, James Coffey. He goes, our AD's a woman. He goes, yep, you sure it's not Falmouth, Maine? So I called Jay right away. I said,
hey, wait a minute. We got to go work.
So I said to Jay, I said, will this game count? Because I was more concerned about it counting.
But
are they Division One?
They don't even have. They just played. They were in the finals last year. They lost in the state finals.
Oh, in Maine.
The team we played.
So
they were decent. Yeah, they were decent. I mean, it gave us a test. I mean, we played pretty well. So, But it was funny because I thought it was Falmouth, funny. Mass, and it wasn't Falmouth. But at least it counted, right. So I, you know, I got a little nervous, and Jay's like, don't worry, it's going to count. That was our
Where
biggest.
Did you play them? Here?
At home. It was a 2.5-hour bus ride.
For them.
You know, so next year he's like, well, what do you want to come out and play us? And I was like, well, if you give us two games with someone else, another main team, or something, right. Make a weekend out of it,
that'd
fun.
Be good.
And those do count toward your Massachusetts.
Yeah, that was my biggest concern because I didn't want to have that, you know, hurt us at the end of the season for that one
So game. How many lines are you running? Are you running four?
I have four lines. We pretty much skate three lines, you know, depending on the game. Sometimes I cut the bench to two lines sometimes, depending, like against Longman.
So
we're
you go
down.
1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-1-2, 1-2,
right.
1-2-3.
Like, depending on the situation, you know. So, I mean, we have seven defensemen, and, you know, we usually run four or five, you know. Some are young. Some are just learning how to play, too. So
goalies?
We have two goalies, sophomore and a freshman. Riley's our starting goalie. She's
the sophomore.
She's the sophomore.
And she started for you last year,
yes,
too, right?
She was a TNG All-Star last year. So we're strong in net. Nora does a great job as a backup. She's actually going to get a start tomorrow against Leominster.
Who was the backup?
Nora Frederick.
Oh, okay.
She's going to get the start tomorrow. So, you know, we try to get her some time in there. It's learning, too. I mean, just practicing with our team, you know, they see some really good shots and everything. So they're getting better, too. So.
Defense, real strong.
Defense is real strong. We're, you know, we have four seniors.
I thought I read the an article. Was there an article in the Telegram?
Yeah. We have four seniors. Our core is all seniors. So this year it's, and then up front we only have one senior that plays a lot up forward. So we'll be strong next year up front, but defensively, you know, hopefully we can
replace
some of the girls.
Retool.
It's gonna be hard to replace,
right.
You know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The leadership that we have too. So.
And how about the perennial all-star? Is she having a good year?
Yeah, she's doing well this year. She's doing good.
Yeah.
Makes your job a little easier.
It does. It does. But, you know, it's great because, you know, they're playing as a real team this year. And we don't have any, you know, again, individualism is not as big. Like, everyone's contributing. And
I see a lot of different scores.
Yeah, we do. We have everyone's chipped in. You know, Delaney, of course, is carrying the bulk of it. But, again, I mean, other girls are chipping in. And so it's good work.
Now, for the people at home who may be watching for the first time, women's hockey is much different than men's hockey. There's supposedly no
checking.
Hitting.
Right.
They hit.
They do. It depends on the refs. Sometimes you'll play a game and the refs will let them mix it up a little bit more than other refs. You know, I think it makes it a better game. When you go up to the college ranks, there's no one-on-one clean checking, but, you know, they let them mix it up more, you know, fighting for the puck and all that. So they let the better refs let them play. And we go out towards Boston, it's pretty much, it's like checking because they let the refs really let them play out there. And I think our girls, it's good for our girls to play that physical game because, you know, they're big, you know, stronger kids and you go against them. We have a pretty big team this year as far as height-wise and size, so that's nice. We really usually have a smaller team, so.
Yeah, I remember we
were
talking
about girl,
Sarah Dorita, she was like 4 feet tall.
Oh, yeah, she was tiny.
She
feisty,
was
one of the most feisty girls I've ever met in my life.
Yeah.
Really?
She was. Yeah. She was giving us crap in the stands when we were watching the boys' game.
Yeah, she was a handful. Yeah. And Sam, you know, Sammy was a good, we've had a lot of good players go through the system.
Yeah,
Sammy played 4 years at Nichols. We've had probably four or five girls go on to play college hockey. Right.
Sam's a great kid.
Yeah, she had really a good career at Nichols. So, I mean, it's been positive, you know, with the you know girls going on and playing at the next level. So
that's really good. Yeah, that's really good.
So locally in Central Mass, who would be the team that you guys look at as good competition out there?
Well, Long Meadow's definitely our biggest rival right now. Yeah. Algonquin, either if they're up or down, Algonquin's having a pretty good year. We played them earlier in the year. We beat them 6-2, but every time we play them, it's always a tough game, you know. So.
Okay.
Give us a little
take a break. Take a break. Take a break. You can hear the music.
But real quick, give us a little warm fuzzy. You're not taking any advice from Ted.
No. He likes to give advice. I love Ted.
We'll be right back with the four. They're all captains, right?
Yes.
All four of them. Yeah. The four are our captains.
I'll get off. We all got to get off.
She already has.
No, I mean boys and girls. Oh, that's awesome. All right, welcome back. Sorry, we're here talking, and some of the faces you see may be a little familiar. They, the two senior defensemen sitting here were on for field hockey. I don't think, Delaney, you haven't been on
no.
before, right? And have you, Karli?
No.
I don't think so, yeah. All right, so they're the newbies. This is Karli DeSouza. Right next to me is Lilly McManus. Over there is Kylian Kelly, not Killian, and Delaney Couture over here. So, girls, congratulations, first of all, on tremendous careers already, especially you seniors and you too, Delaney, just fabulous. 6-0 this year. Have you noticed a big difference going up to Division I?
I say as a team, I feel like we're a lot stronger than we were last year, definitely. And I just think like there's a lot more communication on and off the ice than there was last year.
Now, does that mean you guys are closer?
Yeah, definitely we've gotten closer along the years. Like we've been together for, well, I mean, like me, Kai, Lily, Delaney, we've all been together for 5 years, I think now. And a lot of the SPM girls as well have been together 5 years. We've just kind of grown real close together.
How is it intermingling with rivals? I probably asked you this before, but it is. I mean, Wachusett, you know, no offense, Wachusett people out there watching, we hate Wachusett. You know, we play football, we hate them. How does this work?
Yeah, I know a couple of the Wachusett girls we play against during field hockey, and same with some of the SPM girls, so I guess it's just different in season and out of season. So in season when we're hockey, it's just we're all one big team and nobody's separated. We don't think about the fall season or we don't think about the spring season. We just focus on the season at hand. But during the fall, we'll say hi after the game, but that's about it. We won't say anything else.
So the competitiveness is still there in the off seasons.
Mm-hmm.
Delaney, 5 years, junior captain. Doesn't happen very often. Were you a captain last year too?
I wasn't.
Oh, all right. Well, it doesn't happen very often. How are you handling it? It's different for you.
Yeah, it's a little different. I mean, you guys were both juniors together, so like it's kind of different when I have seniors all around me. But like, we've all been leaders since we were like younger, so it's pretty normal.
Pretty nice to have 5 and 6 year starters.
Absolutely.
Playing for you. Probably a great year to move to Division I. Why don't you talk a little bit about each one?
Well, I mean, starting with Lily, I mean, this is her sixth season with us. Started as a seventh grader, and you know, you just see the maturity and just the playing level.
Is she this big?
Yeah. But I mean, just seeing the level of their play, and you know, just every year getting better and stronger. I mean, obviously, I think the weirdest thing is seeing him start driving. You know, when he's all of a sudden they're seventh grade and then they'll drive by you in a car. I mean, being with them that long, so.
No, wait a minute. I understand that because we've been doing Coach's Corner for 20 years, almost 20 years. So the kids that we originally had on the show are now 38.
Yeah.
And they've got four or five kids of their own, and we see them, we go, oh my God.
It is. It's
so I understand
yeah.
that.
But I mean, Lily, she's a captain this year. I mean, just having that experience back on the blue line, I mean, she's doing a great job. She's on the power play and, you know, produces for us, you know, point wise, and you know, she's been positive for 6 years.
No, not me.
No, she doesn't. She doesn't have it. But it's gotten stronger. Her shot has gotten a lot stronger. Carly's another, you know, captain defenseman. Like I said, these three are out of our four seniors defensemen, so I mean, they bring a lot. But Carly's been there, this is her fifth season, and she's just, you know, they all just strong, you know what I mean? They're learning how to play, you know, now it's not a big thing to play against stronger teams. They're used to that. But these girls, you know.
No intimidation.
You know, Carly's been playing like a senior since probably seventh, you know, eighth grade, ninth grade. She's just always been a physical player, so great job. Kai, same thing. Kai's been very offensive, you know. She adds a lot of scoring to the team as a defenseman.
Booming slap shot.
Out of the three, Karli has the booming slap shot on defense. But Kai, another one, you know, has been with since sixth grade, but it was an impact, seventh grade. She's been an impact player for 6 years. You know, she started with Lily. They were playing as seventh graders. But now as a senior, you can see the leadership and the, you know, as they're growing, they're maturing.
Kind of been there, done that.
Absolutely. You know, and that's hopefully that carries on to the postseason, having the experience of playing in the postseason for every year they've been there. So, and then Delaney, a junior, already set all the records broke every record that's already been established by pretty much Sam Derita. But, you know, I can't say much more about her. I mean, she's definitely our offensive leader.
Come and see her play. She's
yes,
good.
She's you know, started as a seventh grader and scored 20 goals as a seventh grader. So right away we knew we had a special player. I mean, I knew she was kind of special when she was 5 years old. But again, just she's getting better, which is hard to do at a level she's at.
It's the three older brothers. I mean,
absolutely.
You know, I'm sure she'd probably take every one of them right now.
Yeah, well, they weren't easy on her, especially Chandler. Chandler was pretty tough on her. They were close. They were the closer ones in age, so they had their battles. But yeah. No, obviously, I've been part of her life since she's been born. But I've seen her grow up and playing hockey. She's just getting better and better. So it's good.
Johnny, we've got a couple of questions.
Yep, go ahead.
First question is for Coach Frank. Frank, Carla wanted to know, how do you stay humble as a team with a 6-0 record?
This year, we're very humble because the last two seasons, we got knocked out in the first round of the playoffs where we shouldn't have. And I think that's keeping us very humble. We have a job to do. Actually, we made bracelets and the girls, I gave them out to the girls this year. And it says, Shrewsbury girls hockey, and then on the other side, it says, let's finish this 17-18, because, you know, we are good enough to go all the way. So I just want to finish it this year, so.
Yeah, it's tough to win. Well, you won a lot of games,
we
right?
Did. We
the
did.
The last 2 years, and then have to
yeah,
one and done.
Yeah, we didn't have any puck luck at all for the last 2 years. I mean, it just we outshot both teams and outplayed them. It
sometimes
just
a goal
sometimes
we can
it happens.
Do that, right?
Yeah.
How about the speed at Division One? Now I know you guys played divisions a lot of Division One teams and some great teams last year. Have you noticed the speed difference moving up?
A little bit. We haven't really hit like the core of all the Division I teams, but I know last year one of the teams that kind of flew past us a little bit was Needham. They definitely were skating two lines and they were just crazy in shape and they could fly all over the ice very quick. But we haven't seen too much of that yet, but it'll get in towards like midseason, I'm sure.
How about did you all play some kind of I know you did, Delaney, club hockey? Did you all did?
Most of us met from club hockey. Like when I was younger, I played with Delaney and I've played with all of, we've all played together at one point or another, whether it's town or club. And
so you started in town?
Yeah. I actually started a year later than the three of them. And I had started like when I was a little older than them. So I was on a younger team than them.
So Shrewsbury Youth Hockey has girls teams, or were you playing on boys teams?
We were playing on boys teams.
Oh, that's what I thought. Yeah. I didn't think they had girls teams back then. That's good, because I mean, even way back in the 80s when my son played, we had girls playing all the time.
They just started a girls 14 and under team. So they're seventh and eighth graders, which is good because, you know, now the next step.
Yeah.
So I went to a game actually the other night to see a game. I had friends with one of the parents and just going there, a lot of kids came out to me after, which was kind of a nice thrill for them having me there and saying they're going to be going to the high school next year and getting to see them play a little bit. And we're going to invite them to one of our games and have them as our guests and maybe come
in
the locker room.
That's
and yeah,
cool. So we're planning on doing. It's all part of developing a program. That's awesome.
Yeah.
So what club teams, what do you still play on club teams? You all do?
I played this past fall for the Flames still, and I've been with that program for like 10
Flames
years.
Out
yeah.
In Marlboro?
No, I haven't played since freshman year.
Okay. Delaney, who do you play for?
I played for the East Coast Wizards for 2 years. This is my second year. And then before I was with the Flames, I jumped around a lot.
All right, so Frank said that they're one of the best teams in the country.
Yeah.
Did they draw from all? You guys are all shaking.
Her team's really good.
Yeah, really good.
I've seen a game where they went into a shootout and Delaney had to go twice and she scored. It was amazing. Like, it's just crazy.
They have girls from Canada on the team.
We have two girls from Nova Scotia.
Are these all Division I type players?
Yeah, we have Ivy League. Like, it's pretty legit. They're all really good.
And now you've played with them for how long?
Just this is my second year.
This is your second
year.
Will you play again? You'll play again next
year,
too. Yes,
next year I get to play with the U19s, and I only play with them once.
Oh, okay.
But other girls that, repeat, play with them twice.
Now, there may be people out there watching right now that don't know that you've verbally committed to Providence, right?
Providence, yes.
Congratulations on that.
Thank you.
That's great. They're Division I.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. They play in Hockey East.
Yes.
It's pretty good, folks. I'm telling you, come see your play. It's all.
Not a big deal. She's pretty good.
She's not bad.
I think the biggest thing of her doing that is other girls can see that it can happen from public school. You know, it's not just a prep school kid. You know, that it's good that we can get some of those players stay with public school.
You're preaching to the choir. I've said it. I've been saying it for 20 years. If you're good enough,
they'll find you.
It's that simple. It's that simple. You don't have to go play for these, you know, $35,000 high schools. You don't. If you're good enough, they'll find you. All right, I don't want to be remiss. Go ahead.
A quick question for Delaney. Delaney, have you had a chance to play any international teams or any international players or of the sort?
No, I have not. I actually had a chance to play China, but I never made it to that game. But yeah.
Well, she's playing with Canadians.
Well, yeah, that I collaborate with like girls from other countries, but I don't play against them.
Okay. All right. I don't want to be remiss. I want to ask you guys about college. We haven't got much time left. And Lilly, I know you talked to us before, and you're still in the process of trying to go to the Naval Academy.
Yes, I am.
And how's that going?
It's going pretty well. I recently had an interview with Senator Markey, and I'm just waiting to hear back on the nomination. And there's a couple things I have to finish up with the application, and then I got to get that all in soon, and then I'll find out from there.
Okay. Kai, what about you?
The
last one's the most important.
I've been mainly looking into UNH and University of Albany, and then University of Tampa down in Florida.
Kind of quite a difference there, you know, the snowstorm blizzards going down to, you know, bathing suits.
Yeah, very different.
And what do you want to do? Obviously, you want to be in the Navy, but what do you want to do?
Something along the lines of, like, nursing or physical therapy.
Okay. Karli, how about you?
I'm leaning towards Merrimack, and I'm thinking of studying either physical therapy or athletic training.
Physical therapy is long, isn't it? Like 6 or 7 years?
Yeah.
Delaney, I'll ask you next year. So who are you looking forward to on the schedule?
Notre Dame of Hingham. Yeah. We play them twice. We got rescheduled from a snow day, so we didn't get to play them, but hopefully soon.
We've played them in the past, and they've always been a really strong team. And even they're Division II, but they're a team that we've never beat, and I'd like to see us beat this year.
Mm-hmm. You play them here, and then they go out to Hingham?
Out in Rockland.
Okay. Where?
Rockland, Mass. That's where the rink is. It's down near Plymouth in that area. Down there. It's a good ride. Long ride for us. We have a lot. We have a lot of bus time.
A lot of bus time. Yeah. All right. Thank you very much, ladies, for coming on, and good luck with the rest of the season. The sports team's going to try and get out there and tape a game or two. So we'll be looking for you then. Good luck, and good luck with all the college applications too. All right, Frank, go get them.
Okay, thank you.
Let's finish.
Yes, let's finish this.
See you next time.